Our next guest received a Bachelor of Arts degree and a Master of Education degree from Notre Dame and an Executive Doctorate of Education from the University of Oklahoma. He has been a middle school teacher, a Catholic school principal, an adjunct professor at the college level, and the director of a large Catholic school. To quote Cardinal Kevin Farrell, who's now working at the Vatican, right next to the Pope, he is seen as a rising star in Catholic education, and we look forward to his innovative leadership in implementing the strategic plan for Catholic schools in the Diocese of Dallas. Not only that, but this young man is also quite a daredevil. He likes to jump out of planes. And he said he'd do it again. Please join me in welcoming the superintendent for Catholic schools in the Dallas Diocese, Dr. Matthew Vereecke.
Usually after the Japanese, it's the joy of being tall. Well, thank you so much on behalf of the diocese, on behalf of Bishop Burns and Bishop Kelly, for allowing us to be here tonight and share this really special meeting with you. This is a gift for us more than anything else. We have 15,000 kids here within the diocese who are benefiting from Catholic education. But what we know is that there are a tremendous amount out there that are not getting this benefit that so many students so rightly deserve. We have two goals here in the diocese, and that is to make sure every student entrusted to our care has access to college and has access to heaven. And those two goals ultimately inform everything that we do. And this room, this night, all of you out here, these students, we're so happy that there were people who wanted to help your families make this sacrifice that you can be here together. On Friday, Bishop Burns and I actually had a radio show on Guadalupe Radio. One of the things that we talked about is the force of will that families bring to Catholic education. And we talked to a school in Chican, Alaska, where all of their students, because they're actually on an island, take a boat to school every day. And if it's raining, they take a boat in the rain to school. Absolutely amazing, because it's better for them than what the alternative is. And here in Dallas, we know that there's families who sacrifice and work 2 and 3 jobs in order to send their kids to school. Nowhere is that more apparent than over at St. Cecilia. And just this year, we started a new program pilot where we limited tuition to 7.5% of a family's income in order to see, could we get more families into school? And all of a sudden, enrollment has grown 45 kids. The attrition rate dropped from 25% to 6% overnight. And so all of that tells us we are not meeting the needs that we have here in town. That is a message. And yet, here tonight is the hope. These people, the people at your tables, the students that are here, are the next generation. And it proves that this is solvable, that we can ultimately get these kids back into schools and fix these graduation rates and the lack of college preparation and readiness that we see. It is even worse in Texas. 16% is tough. If you right now are a student in poverty and you're in one of our ISDs, it's 8.6%. Right now in the Catholic schools that we have, 60% of our students wind up college ready as they come out. That's great, it's still not good enough. But that's what you're all here for. These outstanding scholars, you outstanding people, we're so thankful for everything that you do to allow us to continue our mission. So again, from Bishop Burns, from Bishop Kelly, from all of us at the diocese, thank you so much for helping us to get kids to college.